Well, hey guys, it is Thursday. How awesome is this weather? It is 75 degrees. I think it is finally breaking. All next week is supposed to be right at 70, 75 degrees. So I think the weather's finally breaking. The allergies, oh, hold on. This truck here, you gotta really watch stuff doesn't fall off of there. You have no options. Just gotta pay attention, hold on. All right, we're clear. But yeah, it's supposed to be like 75 degrees. Yeah, most of next week also. So hopefully the weather has broken. I don't have to bundle up. I don't mind wearing all the clothes. It's just a hassle. I mean, it just takes extra time to get going in the morning, and then you got to stow it on the ride home because you don't need it. So it's just a pain in the neck. So I'll be glad when I could just wear, you know, pants without the bibs in the morning and the jacket, and maybe just shed one jacket from underneath in the morning. But hope everybody's doing great. If you have purchased a Ryker and have gotten it already, message below how you like it. I've seen a bunch of people saying, you know, I'm getting mine next week, I'm getting mine next month. You guys are going to love it as soon as you get it. A little bit to get used to. All right, I'm back. I did a little voiceover there and not voiceover, but a layover with the video. I had to cut it short there just because it was real boring. Let me move over. But yeah, it's absolutely awesome. I see these people talking about they're getting theirs, and it'll take a little bit of use to get used to. With the back wheel being in the center and wanting to track around. Hold on a second. I got to get off on this exit. Let me cut over right here. Hold on. There we go. One more. All right. Yeah, don't trust your mirrors. Always turn your head. Don't be lazy. You're going to end up running into somebody and you're going to get hurt. But yeah, track's a little different. That's all. Once you guys get used to that, it's awesome. I still lend this thing out, you know, people to test drive it a ton. You know, anybody that wants to ride it, yeah, I don't care. You know, it's insured. But most of them have motorcycles and they just want to see the difference. So they ride it around the neighborhood or at work or something like that. Let me make sure clear here. All right, stop. There we go. All right, and you've seen this road before. Is where I do a shortcut, you know, up through town just so I don't go down the highway. It gets real boring. Try to make it a little more exciting for you guys. But that's it. Next week, I'm hoping probably Tuesday, we're going to start on the graphics on this. I believe the red will disappear. New red will be coming on, but it'll be in something different, and then we will change the back fender up with some red and so on. But yeah, we're going to hopefully start with that next week. This is Thursday, so you might be seeing it over the weekend. If not, it'll be the beginning of next week. This video, like I said, I'm storing a couple up so that way if I miss a day or two, you don't miss seeing videos. I will always have one or two sitting stored away. What else? Oh, I've gotten a few comments where people are saying, you know, they'd be really mad if they bought this vehicle and it had rust already. And yes, trust me, I am not very happy about it. And you can tell in some of my videos that it's just unacceptable. They have really failed on the details, and that's one of them, is the rust. The other one is plastic on plastic. I mean, there's rubber insulators you can put in there and all. I put some rubber film in between the plastics where they touch, just to quiet it. You know, that's something they can do. Maybe on the next model that they release, they will be doing that. But for right now, you got to deal with it. And like I said, I think they're going to change things up on the next model, you know, with the complaints. I would say they're probably already making a bracket for the dual saddlebags. I should have mine done, well, pretty much done, but I'm very particular. I want this thing to be a bolt-on, no matter if you have a seat or a bag in the back with the posts. I don't want any issues. I don't want somebody to purchase one. I already have like four or five people that are like, you know, we're in, I want one, and they haven't even seen it. Just the idea of being able to carry the two. But I don't want any issues. I don't want somebody to say, I want to bolt it on, but you can't swing the pegs down, you know, if you sit somebody in the back. Or if you're sitting somebody in the back, it's hitting them in the side, you know, in the butt or the legs. So I'm being very particular. We're remaking them, the brackets. I mean, we even remade them just to have them tilt forward. Hold on a second. Let me cut some of this video out here. And I'll get back up when I get up here. There we go. I'm back. Yeah, and I can overlay video over my voice. So like right here, I'm pulling out onto the road, but I could be going down the highway. It doesn't make a difference. I could, you know, lock in the audio track and lay whatever video I want over it. So if I continue to talk but want to cut the video out, it's no big deal. So that's why you may hear me talking about, hold on, and I'm already cutting the video. But yeah, so I'm real particular on it. And also, I don't want the ability of, with all the work we've put into designing it with CAD and everything like that, to put it out there and then somebody's just sitting there and go to copy it, mass produce it, and put it out on the eBay or somewhere. So we're trying to be a little careful there with a patent or a lock into a patent of when we came up with the idea and the design. There are certain ways to do that because I've done it before. Hold on, red light. All right, I'm back. Should be turning green any minute. Here we go. So anyway, that's it. So yeah, I've had a bunch of people, well, bunch, I say four, you know, that are like, yes, we want one. And so that should be done in another week or two. And I'm sorry for the delay and keep saying it and keep saying it, but I want it perfect. You know, I don't want to just show you something and say, well, I'm still modifying it. I'm still modifying it. So I don't want to release it until it's right. It's like releasing an iPhone until it's perfect. And oh, hold on, they have done that. Release them without them being perfect, and then they update them. All right, enough about that. Sorry. But yeah, the beautiful weather is coming up. And like I said in one of my videos, I will take you guys up through the mountains, like up 130, if you're familiar with Lynchburg and Amherst County here. Beautiful, windy roads up through the mountains. I'll take you on this and show you how it handles the turns and, you know, the mountains. It is full of power. I have started modifying the air intake. I've got a little bit more work tomorrow's Friday. I'm going to do some more work to it. And then I will tell you about the performance. So far, it is definitely noticeable. It is remarkable. And that was just taking out the very front baffle. I will show you in a video. Probably on Monday, I will show you that. Because I want to make sure it's all done over the weekend. And I've got one other little modification to make to it. And I have a feeling it's just going to scream. Like a little screaming demon. All right, another red light. I love these things. I mean, I like taking the back roads because it's a little more exciting, but these red lights drive me crazy. Don't stop me. I want to keep rolling. This thing is too much fun to stop rolling. All right, you guys seen this. Come down here and make a left-hand turn. But yeah, I'll show you a little bit of mods on the air intake. We decided not to go with the larger K&N air filter in the glove box and vent it out to there or even put a hood scoop on it, because you're really not going to gain anything with the inch and a half going into the air intake in the motor. It's still going to choke it right there. So just allowing more air to get in there without any crazy modifications will give us the benefit, or the maximum benefit, without crazy amount of changes. And I will show you that on Monday. What else? Things been running great. Doing good. I'm doing good on gas. I'm still averaging about 40 miles to the gallon. I fill it up about once a week. Hold on. We got another red light. This is killing me. Hold on a second. All right, I'm back. I got to pull in here and get some gas. Talking about gas. I'm really not that low, but I want to fill up before the weekend. But yeah, I fill up once a week, about, you know, whatever. It's a full tank. And I'll do right at 250, 265 miles in the week, you know, with my running around and some fun play. And it runs me, I don't know, 10, 11 bucks, you know, maybe 12 bucks, depending on the gas, where I get it. Sheets seems to be my favorite here in town, in Lynchburg. But if I have to stop at a Shell or something, it's a little more, because they're a little more expensive. All right, let me pull up here, and I will get some petrol. And then I'll pick it back up when we head down the road. Hold on a second. That was only just shy of 4. Alright, done with the red lights. Now I can get back to concentrating. But yeah, so I had, you know, that was just under 4 gallons. And that was a week, just shy of a week. So it does fine on gas for me. I really enjoy it. The highway seems to eat up more gas than around town, keeping the high revs like that, because you're running at 6,000 RPMs going down the highway. At least I do at that speed. So I think that is what's killing the gas mileage, you know, running like that. Or it might be playing a little hard at lights like this and accelerating hard. But heck, that's what it's for. That's why I bought it, is to have fun with it. And these things are crazy fun. They are twitchy little rats running all over the road. But we got another red light up here. And I'm not going to bore you with the rest of the trip down past the airport and all that. You've seen that before. But yeah, hit the like button if you enjoyed it. And definitely leave some comments below if you have one. And if you don't, you're thinking about it, leave a message or a question down below and I'll help you out with it if I can. If not, I'll try to find the answer for you. Like I said, as soon as I can, I'll show you a picture of the bracket with the bags. We're going two different options. One is it buy the bracket alone and you guys look for the bags, or it'll be a complete setup. Bags and bracket all together. But that's it. Everybody have a great weekend coming up. Talk to you later. Bye.